We're on IBC 2019, finally the last day, and I met up with Casey, and he has some really interesting lens that he has, and this very strange looking Setcam camera, and it looks like a sort kind of robot with two big eyes. Yes. Can you tell more about the lenses and this camera system?
Okay, actually this one is a camera for the virtual reality 180, which means it is shooting everything in front of the camera in stereoscopic. When the user, they are watching through the headset in the VR, they can look around and keep seeing everything in 3D. But we need a very high quality lens for that, because some in most of the other fisheye lenses, they only clear the center. On the sideway, when the user look on the side, it becomes soft and blurry, and it's not for the professional. So before we make the camera ready, before we make the lens ready, the big guys in the Hollywood world, they are seeing the VR is not a thing because the quality is not there. But now we get the cinematic grade E2 camera here. Essentially, this housing inside is two E2 camera. Every single feature for E2 will be showing at this body, and they were fully synchronized and shooting for the stereo in the best way. So we are having the cinematic grade VR for the first time.
Okay, and we'll shoot like two media devices, or like on one card that it is directly?
In the final form of these devices, there's an SSD drive for here, so user can plug it in. But at the moment, we are making some pre-production units, so it was recording in two CFast cards, just like the E2, but using two at the same time.
And the sensor size of this box?
The sensor size is the same as the E2. It's a Micro Four Third.
Okay.
Essentially, that's the same as the GH5S. But we are having a much more powerful processor in here, so we can take the limit higher than the GH5S. Dual native ISO.
Also Sony battery and
Sony
the network
battery,
board.
Live streaming through the Ethernet port, live preview via HDMI, and we do have a Wi-Fi connector, so you can use an iPhone to control everything.
So can you tell me a bit more about the lens?
Because for our particular purpose for the VR, we do need a very deep field of view, because we are shooting everything at the same time, so we have to make sure object at a close distance and the far away distance, they are all in good sharp focus. So we are making it a hyperfocal. 1 inch away from the lens, all the way to the infinity, they will be very crispy sharp. And we are having to be the same grade quality fisheye lens for the first time. So we are having a very hard work here. This is the MTF chart. The resolution in the center is keeping all the way to the edges of the lenses, which is much better than the major lens maker around the world. And we don't have a distortion issue with the fisheye. Normal fisheye lenses, they are not following the F-filter distortion. They are more congested on the sideway, more blurry after the warping. We have to make sure every single pixel on the sensor, they are usable for the user application. So no matter it's for VR, for 360, or 3D scanning, photogrammetry, we set them all physically inside the lenses. And we have an APO design. The conical aberration is minimum, much, much better than any other fisheye lens around the world. So we are the king of the VR now.
Yes, so you really took the effort to make the lens on all places perfect, instead of, okay, we have a nice fish eye and it has this speed, but it has some problems, but we don't talk about. You just try to be best on every single point.
Yeah, we have
point.
To, because I have been working for the 360 stuff since 1995, more than 20 years now. From that moment, we have been looking for the right tools for our jobs, but it's non-exist in the market. So we are doing it by myself.
That's the spirit.
Just 6 years ago, I started with making a small fisheye lens for the GoPro. So some of our clients, they buy a lot of GoPro, take their original lens off, put ours on, and shoot for the VR, shoot for the 360. That's how we started this business. But later on, the GoPro, the quality may not be meeting the requirement for the majority video producer.
No.
So we are working with Kinson. The C-Cam, they previously have a smaller E1 camera, which is the smallest Micro Four Third camera in the action camera size. So we are taking them as a building block for making virtual reality devices. So that's how we have so many toys in the house now.
Yes, and that's a nice way to work together.
Yes, and they are very close to our office, so we're just 1 hour apart. So we are having a good cooperation.
So you can really develop the products together.
Yes.
You can show something to them, make a request, or ask how would you solve this problem. And
yes, and for the particular lens requirement, we were developed with the user around the world, because we are selling the GoPro Fisheye lenses for a long history. We have thousands of real users. They're giving a lot of real user feedback to us. So they say, for our work, we need this, we need that. And we are summing up all the requirements and make our next product. This is how we're getting here.
That's really awesome. The user feedback and the whole development.
Yes. We are making a new product, make a right tools for the real user. This is the point.
Thank you to take your effort to develop it. And
yeah. We have been working on this lens for more than 2 years already. So this is time to make the VR to another good high level.
What's the price point and the affordability of this lens?
The lens is already available now. The retail price will be around $1,000.
We have a big screen behind me.
Yes.
Maybe you can show the lens, because it's super wide.
Yes.
Maybe people need to realize how wide. So here we have the big screen, and this is really wide. Can you show where the camera is? And I see here a test chart and where that is.
Yeah, it's actually the camera is here. This is the camera behind the TV. We are showing 200 degrees from here to here. And actually this chart is behind the wall, it's behind the camera. So we're seeing something really interesting.
That support there's on, wow.
Yes, and the lens was tailor-made for the E2. This is on a regular 4K resolution. So 4K is not zooming in full circle. And they have a 4-third mode for the anamorphic, which expand the top and the bottom. We see the full circle in the recording. So it's particularly useful for the virtual reality capture, as well as the full doom production. Some people just point the camera all the way up, and it will see the full surrounding very clearly.
Yeah, I done that once with a fisheye lens, also a really wide one on the GH5. And I put also in the anamorphic modus, and then I had the full image circle. And that was really crazy.
Yes, on GH5 it can fit on the anamorphic 6K mode.
Yes.
You get an extra large resolution for that.
But the problem with a GH5 is you have the handle on the side. So in the image, there's a handle showing up.
Yes.
Just and my camera case has a little tip in the front for top handles, and that was also showing up here in the top. So
and just like the Sony.
Yes.
I have a converter, so it can be mounted on the E-mount system. The handle is always visible.
Yes.
So it's not for the Sony, but it's compatible. But our preferred device would be the E2, which is seeing nothing on the sideways.
Yeah, the Z-cam, it's just a square box.
Yes.
And I think that's the best form factor for a production camera.
That's the beauty of the code development.
Yeah. So because of you, it's still on box and not with handles on it.
Yes. That's perfect for us.
Yeah, good, good, good. Mm. So, Casey?
Yes.
Thank you for the demonstration and all the information.
Thank you, Victor.
And thanks for watching.
Thank you.